Now we are going to discuss about the family Anonaceae. Contents: systematic position of the family, distribution, vegetative characters, floral characters, economic importance, and taxonomic affinities of the family. Now we come to systematic position. This family belongs to class Dicotyledons. It has taproot system and also reticulate venation. These are the main identification characters of the Dicotyledons. And also it belongs to subclass Polypetalae. The petals are free and biclamidous flowers are observed in this subclass. And also it belongs to series Thalamiflorae. We observe the conical shaped thalamus and also superior ovary. And order, it belongs to Ranelis. The main characters of the Ranelis is the numerous number of stamens and numerous number of carpels, and also apocarpus condition is observed. Both the stamens and the carpels are arranged spirally. These are the identification characters of the order Ranelis. And now we come to distribution. This family consists of around 130 genera and 1200 species, and the plants are mostly confined to the peninsular India. Now we come to vegetative characters, and the plants are usually aromatic small trees or shrubs, and sometimes woody climbers, example Melododorum and also Artabotris. And root, taproot system is observed, and stem is aerial, erect, woody. Branching is either sympodial or monopodial, and leaves are arranged alternatively and extipulate without stipules, and simple and entire leaves are observed. Oil passages are observed in stems and leaves. So now we see the floral characters. Here we see the twig, the flower structure, and the floral diagram, seed, and the LSF seed, ruminate endosperm, and also the anther and the fruit, which is aggregated or compound fruit. So inflorescence is mostly terminal and also solitary flower is observed. And in Artabotris, we find the modification in the peduncle. Hook-like peduncle we observe in the Artabotris. It climbs with the help of the hook-like modified peduncle. And the characters of the flower, bracteate, bracteus present, pedicellate, and complete, all the floral parts are present. Actinomorphic, that means it is a symmetrical flower, and bisexual, both andrisium and gynoecium are present, and also trimerous and hypovenous, that means ovary is superior. Now we see the calyx. In the calyx, three sepals are present, which are polysepalous, that means sepals are free, aestivation is palpate. And in the corolla, usually three petals are observed, as in case of the Annona squamosa. And six petals are observed in case of the Artabotris, and petals are free. That's why it is included in the subclass Polypetalae, and also it shows the imbricate or volvate aestivation. And the thalamus forms a large conical or convex structure above the perianth. Now we see the characters of the andrisium. In the andrisium, numerous free stamens are arranged spirally. And each stamen has a short and thick filament, and broad dioecious anther is observed, and dehiscence is longitudinal and extrores. This is the andrisium. Stamens are arranged spirally. And in the gynoecium, many carpels are arranged spirally, and they are free. So it is also called apocarpus condition. Ovary is superior, unilocular ovary is observed, and in the ovary, anatropous ovules are arranged in parietal placentation. That means anatropous ovules means inverted ovules. They are attached to the ovary wall. That's why it is called as parietal placentation. And pollination is by insects. It is also called entomophily. And usually we observe the aggregate of berries or compound fruit in case of the Annona squamosa. We come to floral formula. BR, that means bracteate. EBR means is E. bracteole. Bracteole is absent, and we find the actinomorphic flower, symmetrical flower, and bisexual flower, and K3, that means sepals are free and they are free. And when we see the corolla, either three petals or six petals are observed. If they are arranged in two whorls, it is shown as 3+3 condition. And A-infinitive, that means stamens are numerous and they are spirally arranged. And in the gynoecium, we observe the numerous carpels in apocarpous condition and hypogynous flowers are observed. The economic importance of the family: it provides edible fruits, ornamentals, timber, and oils. Edible fruits are observed in Ananas guanosa, that is also called custard apple or Sitapalam in Telugu, and in Anuna reticulata, it is also called bullock's heart or Ramaphalamu, and Anuna muricata, it is also called Sarsap or Lakshmaphalamu. These are the edible fruits. And flowers of Artabotrys uncinnatus, it is also called Sampenga. It yields essential oil, which is useful in perfume preparation and toilets preparation. And this is Anuna squamosa, Anuna reticulata, Anuna muricata, and Artabotrys uncinnatus. Ornamentals. Artabotrys is a straggler and it yields fragrant flowers, and Kananga odorata, it also is a, it produces the fragrant flowers. And taxonomic affinities: this family is closely related to Magnoliaceae family. It shows similarity in vegetative and reproductive characters except in the presence of the ruminate endosperm in the seeds. And it also differs in having reduced perium. And the family was divided into five types with Bentham and Hooker. Thank you.